marriage gives permanence, structure, and security to a couple's love. A successful marriage must be built on one understanding. That love is a choice. It's a choice that you make, a choice that you make every day. A covenant is how God has chosen to have a relationship with us through Christ. Therefore, a covenant is what he also asks you in turn to enter into in a relationship with one another. A covenant provides safety, security, peace, hope, and love. That is built on knowing that the person making it will keep their promise, that they are trustworthy and faithful. The reason we find confidence to enter into a covenant with God is because those are the things in his nature and in his character.
From Genesis 31:49, the Lord says, "May the Lord keep watch between you and me when we are away from each other."
Love is patient. Love is kind. Love is not jealous or boastful or proud or rude. It does not demand its own way. It's not irritable. It's not easily angered. And it keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but it rejoices with the truth. It always protects. It always trusts. It always hopes. It always perseveres, and love never fails. That is why choosing to love, by this definition, is the secret to a successful marriage, and it is how God has chosen for you to love one another.
I have, for the first time, found what I can truly love. I have found you. You are my sympathy, my better self, my good angel. I am bound to you with a strong attachment. I think you good, gifted, lovely, a fervent. A solemn passion is conceived in my heart. It leans to you, draws you to my center and spring of life, wraps my existence about you, and kindling in pure, powerful flame, fuses you and me in one.
Brittany, at this time I ask you, do you take Daniel to be your husband, to live together in the covenant of marriage? Do you promise to love him, to comfort him, to honor and help him in sickness and in health? And do you promise to forsake all others and be faithful to him as long as you both shall live?
You.
Daniel, I ask you, do you take Brittany to be your wife, to live together in a covenant of marriage? Do you promise to love her, to comfort her, to honor her, to help her in sickness and in health? And do you promise to forsake all others and be faithful to her as long as you both shall live? By the power vested in me, by the state of West Virginia, I now pronounce you husband and wife, and you may now kiss your bride.